Hello, ladies and gentlemen of YouTube. You are watching a Zendikar Rising Best of Three Traditional Draft with Travis Simulansours on Twitch. If you'd like to watch the drafting live, you can do so at www.twitch.tv/simulan. Chat, say hello to YouTube. I'm sorry y'all didn't get a video yesterday. I was not feeling particularly well, and so decided to skip it. But we should be good to go today. My only issue is a little bit of mouth pain. I could get behind a Legion Angel, a Warrior, maybe even a Mystic. I kind of just feel like taking the Deadly Alliance, though. I have the ability to draft a four-color pile, but like I always like to go bombs, removal, additional value. I don't feel like there's legitimately a bomb here. I think I'll just take the removal spell and see where we go. I know everybody's laughing that it's going to be Golgari, and it might be, but there's no guarantee. Like, I will get into other colors. It's just going to take something to push me there. The Minotaur is not a bad card. I like it quite a bit, and it would put us set up for a black-red party deck. I could be very interested in that. If there was a black card that was on par with these, I'd probably rather take it here. And I like the Geyser Mage a lot, too. But I think getting past this Minotaur is... Well, I'd like to say it's a signal and pretend I know what I'm talking about, but it's not. There's one card missing. It was rare. We have literally no idea what it was. So the way I like to draft is to try to take the best card out of every pack until it becomes apparent what's open, and then draft that. So I think the best card in this pack is the Minotaur. We'll take it and then see what we get. Here we've got Nahiri's Binding, which is our removal spell. Geopede, which is pretty dang good at chonking people to death. And a Blood Beckoning, as well as a Bug Catcher. So it's kind of time to make a little bit of decision about how much we'd like to commit to the party theme. Because we're sort of getting a red signal here. But I think if we're going to commit to the party theme, we want to take the Bug Catcher here. Now, it still would not be difficult for me to get into Golgari, as you all very well know. And we'd miss having this Blood Beckoning. But we could just be in red-white warriors and not know it. Or we could pretty happily buckle into black. Yeah, let's do it. This is cutting the heck out of black, which is the main color I'd like to be. And then we'll see what else we can get into. And this pack leaves a good bit to be desired. I think out of this pack, I probably want the healer. It's not that I wouldn't play a silencer or a kite sail in a red-black party deck. It's that I shouldn't have to be picking them here. Like, if you're fifth picking these cards, things are going wrong. So we may as well take this, and if we see a Relic Vial, we can shift in the Clerics, and if we see, like, I don't know, the Kargan War Leader or whatever, we can be like, okay, we'll go into white. This pack is also leaving a good bit to be desired, but it's just a weak pack. It's not the pack's fault. There's just really not much here. I'll play this in most of my decks. I'll play a Dreadworm too. Like, it's fine. So is the Ox. So is the Plunder. They're all just fine cards. Second Vanquish has me interested, and I do think we're buckling into black now. But I'm pretty good with that. I don't like Spellcraft very much. It's killing most of the same things that Vanquish the Weak is, but costing two more mana to do it. And I could be interested in a Seagate Colossus, but I've already got one. And this is where we start to see what's actually open versus what's not. And we've been past a Fisher Wizard and yet another Vanquish. I usually want about two Vanquishes. This is good news, though. It means that black is indeed open. And this pleases the Travis. But I'm going to grab us the Wizard here. I like this guy. I think we're actually going to play black-red, which is unusual for me. I'm used to playing Golgari, but we can make it work. Umara Wizard went literally all the way around the table. Okay. We can think about it. What else you got? Like, it would hurt a little bit to let go of the Alliance and the two Vanquish the Weeks, but I'm down. Got a Duelist, a Skittersnick, Tormenting Voice, Silencer. This pack's pretty bad. If we are on the party plan, though, I'm usually pretty happy to have one Silencer in the deck, so we'll take it here, but I'm not excited by this. This may mean that blue-red specifically is open, but blue just isn't. Yeah, because, like, you don't really want to be playing a deck with a Skyclave Squid in it. But I'll still take it. It could happen. I think we're probably not in white. Probably not doing the Wizards. We're probably just doing Black-Red Party. But I could still be moved ever so slightly. Priorities for us going forward for a party deck would be more Bug Catchers and the 3-2 Electromancer. And then obviously any sort of recursion like a Thwart the Grave or a Blood Beckoning. But I do think you want as many Bug Catchers as possible. Now, I don't often play Sneaking Guide, but you can play it in this deck. If we get enough Bug Catchers, I probably will. And one Silencer's enough. For Rogues, I'd probably want the 2-1 Flying Rogue, if we can get it. I kind of want a Masterpiece Art for Highborn Vampire. I think this card is just a little underrated. Alright, so we've got a Hellion, a Warrior Dude, a Relic Amulet, Spare Supplies. I wonder if we take the amulet and just, like, look a little bit towards that blue-red thing. Because I think we'd play the Hellion, and I think we'd be happy playing the Hellion. We'd probably play this, we'd probably play that. We might even play a Spitfire Lagak. I'm likely to wheel one of those cards. I'll probably at least wheel a Spare Supplies, which I don't mind playing. So let's just keep our little, maybe we're playing blue-red pile here and think about that. We got past a Soul Shatter, though. People just not want removal? Yeah, I think if this has been a 5-drop, it would have been better. It's still playable, it's just not great. It's also worth keeping in mind that creatures are relatively small in this set. With a few exceptions. Yeah, I don't think that's what I'm doing. I think this is what I'm doing. I need to see one heck of a blue signal here for me to, like, change my mind. Because we could just play the guide and have a pretty good start here. There you go, Milton. Yeah, I was streaming Kaladesh all morning for those of you watching on YouTube and thought, I think I've been doing like maybe ones into card draft a day since Kaladesh has been out. Pack does leave a bit to be desired. Namely Bug Catchers. I don't really have enough 2-drops to pull this off consistently, and we haven't seen the Wizards, which has me a bit concerned. It's like, yeah, I'll play a Hellion, but I'm not like excited to take it here. There's some pieces missing in the curve. I'm going to grab it and still be ready to move into blue and maybe just let go of the red. Because like, if you think about it, why are we playing red? We're playing red because we have a Minotaur, a Fisher Wizard, and a Bug Catcher. We might should just be blue-black party. I think I'm actually supposed to be doing that. I think there's a high probability that's what I'm supposed to be doing. Because I don't feel like red's actually open here. That was very close. But I don't feel like red's open here. I feel like blue is. Let's pretend we're doing that for a moment and see what that starts to look like. It looks like we've got good removal and medium creatures, which is a fine way to win a draft. Dude, my APM is absurd. I can literally do one action per minute. The straight 1-0 on APM. I have the reflexes of a 42-year-old man. It's almost always green that's open, though, isn't it? There's also an Electromancer here. That's not too bad, Monarch. I'll be a 43-year-old man before too long. This Electromancer gives me some grim hope that I should switch back into the black-red. This is the last pick I can make and still bounce back and forth on this. So hopefully we get some kind of signal for literally anything here. We just kind of don't. I can take a Molten Blast, which I'll play. I think I have to do. There's a Fledgling here, but like I think it's too late for us to move in on that. Okay. I'm not terribly unhappy with where Black Red is going now. It's got a little bit of a plan. It doesn't really have the super aggressive start that I would like, though. Like, I think we're going to be doing Black Red things. I don't think we're going to be particularly thrilled about it. I'm probably going to need to use a Subtle Strike and then fill this with just pretty medium creatures. Like, probably playing the guide. But we've just been waffling back and forth. I fully expect to see a pick seven. I was expecting the duel for Golgari, not this. That doesn't make any sense. Huh. Draft, ladies and gentlemen. Okay. I'm not getting into Cleric's bazillionth pick. I think we're actually supposed to take this and settle in. I know it has lifelink. I don't think that's what we're looking for. I think we need to make sure we have our party bases covered. Like, we're looking at getting a mediocre black-red party deck, and I think if I try to get into anything else, it's probably too late. If we see another mace, I will take it. Happily. But right now, I need to make sure I have enough two drops. Because the first one isn't even that good. We're kind of like a bad red-black warriors deck. But medium creatures, decent removal is a way to win a game. We can do something with that. I feel like maybe literally everything was open except for this. This reminds me of like the first drafts I did with Battle for Zendikar. But I don't think it was Golgari this time around, even though we did get those Sapperling dudes. I can't remember what it's called. The Gravedigger for green. I'm probably going to end up playing a combat trick. And it currently looks like Sneaking Guide may be in the deck. which is not really a sign of a deck that I'm excited to play, but it's not necessarily a bad one. Yeah, black removal and other cards. That's kind of what's happening here. Just a really difficult draft to navigate. I'm enjoying that. Like, the Skulker looks really bad here. The Sneaking Guide seems, like, kind of bad, too. I mean, sure, there's combos. We can activate it and attack with a Bug Catcher, but that kind of depends on us being way ahead of our opponents. We need to open something really good to, like, confirm that Black-Red was a good place to be. But we do need another Teeter Peak Ambusher. Like, our two-drop slot could use a little help, so I'm pretty happy to see that here. There's just been no real indication that Red's open is the biggest challenge that we're facing. But I guess this guy would be okay too. I am interested in another Fisher Wizard. I don't want to play this Skulker. So come on in, buddy. Yeah, Red's just not open this direction. I want this Electromancer, but I need to take this Royal Eruption. Like, this part of the curve has some problems. And that there's nothing there. It's a bit of an issue. Yeah, it's filling out nice. Maybe we're really more of a pack four deck, if you think about it. Because this pack is making me sad. That I don't need this. I don't need that. I don't need any of that. Yeah, but if you're using removal on turn three, you're pretty unhappy. May still have to fill with this. At least has a party tag. Okay. On in, buddy. Blood Priest? Sure. So we got twos and sixes. I don't need the rest. This is what you call a curve. See how it curves from here over to here? That's what's known in Magic as a curve. The rainbow curve. It's the rainbow. I'm legitimately shocked that we're getting a three drop. I kind of want to take the predation, but yeah, I'm still going to. I like the idea of having at least one spell land here, although that guy would have been good for us. If I have to just play the 1/4, I can play the 1/4 as the last card. Which is not exactly exciting, but it is what it is. I do think I'm playing the Sneaking Guide. I'm not particularly thrilled about playing the Sneaking Guide. Yeah, I would expect that too. I don't want to, but I would expect that. Relic Vial went all the way around the table, but here we go. We got another three. We are safe. We're good to go. I can even play this now. Means I may not have to play the Sneaking Guide if I don't want to. But I think he's still providing some value. This deck may just want to cut the silencer. Take this in case somebody has a Crawling Barrens. It's actually a pretty reasonable sideboard card. Puts our creature count right at 15. We even have two Lithiform Blights for the sideboard. All right, I am ready for the Crawling Barrens deck. Let's do this. I think I'd rather the Hellion than the Dreadworm. Well, my two drops are already kind of in threat territory with removal, right? And we are so ready for the Crawling Barrens deck. But no, I don't think I want the equipments in this deck. I would have played another Mace if we'd seen one, but like, it's not the end of the world that we didn't get one. This looks like pretty reasonable to me. Yeah, we're ready for Crawling Barrens and Ashaya for sure. I think this looks actively good. Well, okay, actively good might be a bit much of a stretch, but it doesn't look bad. Ashaya has one weakness, butt fires. Yeah, I could see that. All right, I think we've got a stream raid ready to go, so let's fight that battle. Thank you very much, Nexus, for the bits. Ain't no party like a Rakdos party. Huh! Fair. What's up, Keep? Howdy, howdy. Y'all spam some cats for Nexus. Thank you for the bits, my friend. I appreciate that. All right, we've got Animaniac with the kills, Orcish with the assists, Gold for Con Boss, Grumpy, Detective, and General Snus. That was a very weird draft. A very weird draft indeed. Oh, you were on my left, so you turned it off. Okay. What'd you get into? Black Red Party. Okay, then we did it right. We should be drafting different decks. That's good news. So we've got not a great opener, but a keepable opener. Any land and we can start killing stuff, which isn't exactly... Well, we can cast the Sky Dancer and then start killing stuff. And we're on the draw, so we're likely to hit a land. Which we did. But we're in danger, as they say. I'm trying to decide here if I just want to... I think I do need to just Subtle Strike this, because I'm going to take 9 damage off of it if I don't. I don't think I would have done it if they hadn't played their land drop first. Yeah, but being at 11 is scary. It's real scary. I don't want to be at 11. Yeah, I think I still have to be reactive here and kill this. This kind of sucks. That's how strong the Shade is. It will put you in danger just that quickly. Okay, you got me. Yeah, it's fine by me. I think we got what we wanted out of that too. Okay. Mean, at least I'm not taking the two. They're gonna draw the card though, but like draw the card. I got two draws that just win the game immediately. It'd be nice to hit one of those. That's not one of them, but okay. Now imagine that while all of that had been happening, we were taking three damage a turn. We would be dead. I would not like that. That is a really cool 0/1 you have. Oh, it's a 0/0. That's a shame. I was holding the two lands so I didn't have to discard if they had a Mind Rot Ranger. Like, I'm going to draw another land at some point. But I didn't want to discard the Deadly Alliance. I mean, that's the secret. Mind Rot's playable nearly every format. The Kaladesh Mind Rot's playable too. It's not as good. They had to play it just to not die there. Bye-bye. All right, so we are up against Rogs. The sneaking guide's not going to be great. The silencer may at least be playable here because it's going to ping off a lot of stuff. The thing I'm most scared of is probably the Nighthawk Scavenger. They do have an anti-cognition and a mind rot. We need to be aware of that. And most of the removal appears to be feed the S-worm. But I think I can see something like this being a little more valuable. They are looking to rob a lot of wind. So like the Sky Dancer's not looking phenomenal. It may be just looking to get out of here. We'll try to make our deck a little more powerful. Not necessarily. Crud, thank you for the gift sub, man. I'll spam some cats for Crud. That puts us up to 652. No, 653. Plus the 74 Dream Raider skins. Old Man MTG can tell us what that total is. Thank you very much, Crud. Meh, it's ugly, but we'll keep it. Hope things are well in your world today, Crud. They do have a Thought Thief. Neat. Kind of need those lands, though. Like, I really need those lands. Know how they felt last game? Like, it kind of sucks that they milled four, but not much we could have done about it. They've got a Subtle Strike too, which kind of sucks. That Shade is really hard to keep pace with. When you're missing land drops. Which we are... They do not have a Subtle Strike. Okay, so you're saying there's a chance. Not much of one. But a chance. Yuck. Okay, never mind. There's no chance. The world is only pain. Ouch. Dude. What the heck? I have a very limited amount of time to draw a deadly alliance, then we can die to the shade. Instead, we draw the We just got to do 18 points of damage next round. I'm pretty sure we can handle that. Oh! Somehow our three lander that never drew another land didn't get there. I'm confused as to how that works. That Nighthawk is the scariest thing they have, and we need to be able to kill it. So I can't be using things like I can't play this card early. Yeah, that was at least nice of them. But I think if we can, like, Pervoot, we might stand a better chance. Yeah. But at the same time, like, you can't really be too grumpy about Mana Screw, because, like, if we could have just as easily flooded out, right? Like, if I'd drawn lands, maybe I wouldn't have drawn the spells. Like, we just lost, much like Trump, and arguing about it doesn't actually help anything. It just makes you look stupid. You know? Not the curve out I want, but it's a reasonable opener. I think I can respect that. I'll still see if you want to, like, play the 1/3 rogue first and then kill that, but yeah, I'll just see what they play. I don't think I care about one card getting milled. Bork, bork. Who's a good boy? Yeah. Land me. Not a bloody land. You're supposed to be a land. Like, the one upside we have going for this is it can't block, but that means I gotta be able to race it. Which I can sort of halfway do now.
This is going to get ACOG'd, but it's all right.
It's not ACOG'd? Interesting. Well, now. Hey-ya! I like the way that one turned out. Lol, mage. Alright, chat, I need a quick potty break, and we're recording our YouTube draft, so that means I need you to spam all of the emotes that you possibly can for a few moments to entertain YouTube. Can you do that for me? And I'll be right back with you. Twitch chat never lets you down. Thank you, boys and girls. This is sort of like the opener we were wanting to get, right? With Bugcatcher into stuff. I mean, ideally we hit more lands, but... Probably don't need this. Because we may just be looking to force some damage here. Want to kill that or combat trick it? Probably want to combat trick it. You're blocking something with trample. Yeah, we can keep that. It would appear they've had enough. This is the same opponent I just played. That kind of sucks. Like, I was thinking these cards look a lot familiar, and then I realized I literally just queued into the same opponent again. That's kind of rough for them. I think probably less rough for me, but pretty rough for them. I remember bringing in the silencer against them. I think so too, because that kind of sucks from like their perspective. The pool probably is a bit small with everybody playing Kaladesh right now. That's fair. So like, it is what it is. I'd still rather have that happen than have to wait 2 hours for a match. But I didn't notice it was literally the same opponent. I guess it's unlikely we'll play him 3 times. Yeah, I feel bad for them getting matched into the same deck twice when you lose. Kind of sucks. But it is what it is. All right, I think we're ready for the Stream Raiders battle. Let's battle. Rawr. See the rogues going for the treasure chests, as rogues often do. This is a big battle. It's kind of cool to watch. But I believe we've turned the tide. Mostly just enemy bombers. Yeah, it's one of the bigger maps I've seen for Stream Raiders. I didn't know they made them this big. Which just gets you into awkward spots where now half of our army is just walking across the map, but like, it's okay. Because we're pretty clearly good here. They just got outranged, outtanked, outwitted, outplayed, outsurvived. What was it? Outlast, outwit? Something, something. Somebody knows what I'm talking about. It's not me. Crizzy with the kills, Paul with the assists, Scrolls for Quintus, Keep, Hi-Rez Brian, Shivan, and Rocky. And we got to the blue chest. Huzzah. Let us smush them. I'll pew pew this time. All right, and we got one more on this, and then I'm thinking corn dog. Well, so much better than yesterday. It's just bizarre how much difference a day makes. It's the first day in a week I haven't been on Advil. But autoimmune conditions suck. If you want to imagine what it's like to have Behçet's, imagine being exhausted for 2 weeks and then like you tried to swallow a nest of hornets. It's not fun. All right, this is a decent opener. Glad to hear it, Rocky. Well, it was a decent opener. Can we go back and I play against the same opponent again? It's like the only reason you play this on turn one is because you've got two more in hand. Yep. That is literally the only reason you would do that. I don't think I can do anything about Rooster Drakes. Except be sad. I can be sad. Dave, I want you to know the game you said that you were watching earlier where you're like, this is the second time I've watched you lose after playing Fumigate. I won the game. I won the game. I won the video game. I know, you said I was behind. And I was. However, I was still pretty tickled. I think I figured out how we're going to win the game from here. Still ain't saying it's likely, but I think I figured it out. Yes, that's part of the plan. Hope that they don't draw lands. I don't know what they hit, but I hope we can kill them. This is the other plan, is just keep attacking with crap until they die. Yes, I'd like to predation a kicker spell, but I'm not going to take a turn off of beginning the beats for five. Now we will, though. What you working on over there? Oh, I'd like to take that, but I can't. We'll just take this instead, and it'll be okay. My best shot is that they bounce the ambusher here. Because if I attack with both and they bounce this guy, I don't want to spend the mana. if they're going to play at instant speed, this is just miserable. Oh, this is so rough. I presume they've got another smell shield by now, too. Does Rampage even do anything here? My guy's still gonna die. I don't think I actually care. It must be another end of the Royal, which I'm not beating. Yeah. I wasn't beating it anyway, is the problem. I could see going mono blue if you're going to get two Roosted Drakes. That's just for flex points, which I can appreciate. I don't particularly like our odds here. But this is about all we got, is try to have the most aggressive opening we possibly can. So I'm going to bring in another sneaking guide, which I don't particularly like, but here we are. Once I've done that, I could probably play a Skulker, but I may actually need to. Ooh, what a world. All right, we're just skipping these turns entirely. We're on the play, so let's just be as aggressive as possible and try to maximize the potential for a turn three or four. Hasty Minotaur. This does not really have the potential for that, but it's also not quite bad enough to throw away. There could also be a bug catcher on top into a wizard or something. So it could get there. Roost is the worst card. I'd rather lose to Roost than the Crab, but they both suck. Like, that's why we're going to make the Simulan Cube. It's going to be bad. And you're going to love it. Not really the two drops we were looking for, but that's all right. In a cube, yes, but in my cube, we're going to try to mimic limited sets of days gone by. Where the spells are good and the creatures are kind of meh unless you're green. Yeah, maybe Roost can be the only kicker card that I produce. I could get behind that. Yeah, I think I'm okay with this. Get out of my way. I came to beat face. You can do anything you want in a cube, but no one ever does, at least that I've ever seen. They just put all the powerful cards they can in a set, in a draft set. Like, most cubes are, Dave, this, again, grumpy old man, and I, it is what it is. Bear in mind, I'm in a great deal of pain right now. So, like, take my grumpiness with a bit of salt. But most of the cubes I've seen are like you had five people over to play Legacy, and when they were done, they just threw their decks in a box, and then you shook it up, and were like, you want to draft packs out of this? It's like, that's one thing you could do. But what if you actually like Limited? Like, I like those cubes. They're fun in small doses. But what if you're like, man, I just want to draft Borderland Minotaurs and have them be good. What would that be like? Because believe me, Borderland Minotaur is legal in Arena. It's going in my cube. So I expect we'll be playing a lot of common creatures and a lot of rare removal spells. I'm thinking that green might be the color that would get the fixing, but this is all in the future. Because at some point I want to do a big Simulan Cube tournament and give away a bunch of store credit to face-to-face games. But first I'd have to design the cube, and we'll look at that at some point. You mean the Roost of Drakes deck isn't very good when you don't draw Roost of Drakes? Go figure. I don't want a rareless cube. I'm not looking to make a low-powered cube, necessarily. I'm looking to make one that mimics the set design from 15 years ago. Which is, if you can imagine, just add one mana cost to literally every creature and then subtract one mana cost, or maybe two, from every removal spell. You're good to go. So I think we're going to be playing a lot of rare removal spells and a lot of common and uncommon creatures is where I'm at now, I think. So we can beat them when they don't draw Roost of Drakes. That's neat. I like that. I think I would have enjoyed Kamigawa. I didn't really play much during Kamigawa. Fatal Push probably wouldn't be very good in what I'm designing. Because the creatures you'd be winning the game with would be 5 and 6 drops. But I've heard from people that Kamigawa was very good. I think I might have enjoyed it. I don't know how I can beat them without the curve out, so let's cross our fingers and see what we can do here. Sorry, we are doing the YouTube draft. I'm sorry, YouTube, to derail, but sometimes chat gets interesting. Let's be fair, usually chat's interesting. Sometimes I'm interesting. This has all of the cards I want, but not the ability to play them. I don't think I can actually keep that. Like, we're 74% chance to draw one land. If we do, I can then discard something that doesn't matter, like a Subtle Strike, to try to find the next one. This one's tough. This one's really tough. But I think I need to be the aggressive deck here, which means I'm going to need to mulligan more often than I normally would. Like, I think this is arguably better. Because we can at least get the Bug Catcher attacking pretty quickly. Yeah, hands with no lands are all gas. That's fair, Rocky. But like on the draw with a one lander in the blind, I'll often keep that. But this is just not a scenario where I think that's feasible. I need to be the aggro deck here. Because their late game's beating me. Yeah, Bubble Snare would get them started. I suspect they're just going to play a 3-2 here, which is not really good enough to stop me for very long. So we'll see if they have the Bubble Snare or not. If they're mana deprived, we may be onto something here. Doesn't look like they are. That's a shame. Kind of need the red. I need to find another red, or this is just not realistic. Because our game plan currently is to... What? Okay. Is to draw a mountain and kill them. I'm really confused by that line. They must have End of the Royal. It's the only thing I can figure. Chilling Trap, maybe? But all of a sudden, this game got a lot more interesting. Nothing much we can do here except play this dude. I imagine they've got an ACOG for it, but like, it is what it is. I don't think I'm supposed to send here, but let's see. It was a good time to have used the one time already, Dave. Their deck's not super bad. Also, let's not criticize the opponents. If you want to criticize somebody, criticize me. It's better not to criticize anyone. These are my thoughts on the matter, but every card has a place. And I don't like beating up opponents who draft something questionable. I played a deck yesterday in Kaladesh that was just straight up garbage. Like, impressively bad. That is a piece of wood that my father carved to be in the likeness of a catfish. But not an actual catfish. Yeah, if you're doing monocolor, you're going to have subpar cards too. But like, they've got two Roosted Drakes and a deck built to try to find it. It's a plan. It's not a plan I'd often go for, but looking pretty good right now. My best bet is to try to finish him off by surprise next turn, which I still don't think is likely. Yeah, they probably got me now. Like, 6 mana, 5/4 worth of power, balance your dude. You're not beating that. Nobody's beating that. And we're pretty straight up just dead next turn. Like, it's bad. Oh, it's bad. They need to make a big mistake not to kill me here. This is not them making a big mistake. I still have to block everything. And we've got like a 5/5 haster, but it's not going to work. Yeah, we can say their deck sucks, but they're the ones getting the gems. I've also found it's just not a good idea to underestimate your opponents. Like, if you see someone playing subpar cards, they probably have a reason. The reason may be because they're bad at Magic. If that's the reason, you're probably going to win. If the reason is because they have a plan that you're not thinking about, it's better to take that into consideration and try to plan and prepare around it. Because I think that was pretty cool. They opened Roost of Drakes and were able to maximize it more than I think any time I've ever opened it. So I'm down with what they did there. Alrighty, YouTube, that's going to do it for the YouTube draft. Chat, say goodbye to YouTube. If you would like to watch the drafts live, you can do so at www.twitch.tv/simulan. Hope we see you on the stream sometime. Y'all have a great afternoon, or evening, or night, or whatever it is when you're watching this.